Good morning, students. Today I will discuss about material balance. So before going deep into this discussion, let me recall the topics which we have covered in the last class. So last class we have discussed about units and dimensions. Units and dimensions. There are basic units, this meter, kilogram, and second like that. Then derived units, that is pressure, kilogram, kg per second like that. We have discussed about basic units and derived units. Coming back to the topic material balance. What is material balance? Why it is necessary and how to write the material balance. Before that, I like to give a brief introduction about the stoichiometry principle. Consider this equation, C plus O2 gives CO2. Here 1 mole of carbon reacts with 1 mole of oxygen to give 1 mole of carbon dioxide. But in actual practice, in an industry, the materials are handled in terms of kilograms. So we have to convert these moles into kilograms. So 1 mole of carbon means 12 kgs of, we have to multiply the moles with molecular weight. The molecular weight of carbon is 12. So 1 mole of carbon implies 12 kilograms of carbon plus 32 kilograms of oxygen will give the 44 kilograms of carbon dioxide. So to produce 44 kilograms of carbon dioxide, I have to use 12 kilograms of carbon and 32 kilograms of oxygen. So total weight, I am taking 44 kilograms of raw material to produce 44 kilograms of product. Here there is a principle behind this principle, stoichiometry. That is called law of conservation of mass. Mass neither can be created nor can be destroyed. Here the 44 kilogram is entering the system and 44 kilogram is leaving the system. This is called, that is input. What are the input given to the system is leaving assets. Input is equal to output. So this is called material balance. So material balance will tell you that how much the quantity of material entering the system and how much the quantity of material leaving the system. To know what is the actual quantity of raw material I have to handle, for which I am writing this material balance. So here the input is equal to output. I am sending 44 kilograms of raw material, I am getting 44 kilograms of product. But in actual practice, it is not true. We have to take some percentage of excess reactant and we will get some quantity will accumulated. That is, in that case, the input equal to accumulation plus output. The first one is called as unsteady state material balance and the second one is called steady state material balance. So the aim for writing the material balance is to know what is the flow of material into the system and out to the system. Now we can see how this material balance can be classified. So material balance without chemical reactions the chemical reaction. Again, this is subclassified into steady state operation and unsteady state operation. Here also, steady state. Unsteady state. So this we will discuss in the next class. To summarize the today's class, to write the material balance, one should understand the principles of stoichiometry.